can revise the chapter gravitation. So first we can start with the Newton's law of gravitation. So what is Newton's law of gravitation? If there are two masses are there, m1 and m2, they are separated by distance r. Then gravitational force between these m1 and m2 is directly proportional to the product of their mass and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So you can write F is equal to g into m1 m2 by r square. For example, the acceleration this one is acceleration due to gravity. Kassar is r of mass m, which is object is there of Kassar small m. Then, what is the acceleration because of this gravitational force of r? Is given by g is equal to g m by r square. Now, how this gravitation due to acceleration due to gravity will vary? For example, here, Earth is not a perfect sphere. The distance from the center of the Earth to the equator will be more. This distance is more compared to the distance from the center to the poles. If distance is more, then what happens? G will be less. So distance is more here. G is less at the equator, and it will be more at the poles. Now, with the height, how it will vary? So, for example, here, what is r here? Actually, r is the distance from the center of Earth to that object or from the surface. Now, if we increase this one, for example, this is r of radius r, now the object is here at a height h. Then, what is the total distance here? R plus h. So, distance from the center is increased. If this is increased, g will, what happens? It is decreased. So, it is. G is decreases with the height, with the depth. So if we calculate with the depth, you will get the equation. Acceleration at a depth d is given by g into 1 minus d by r. So what is d here? Depth from the surface. So here also, g is decreases. So g will be highest on the surface of Earth. Now at the center, if you go, this d will become r here. So what do you get here? 1 minus 1. At the center, will be acceleration due to gravity will be 0. Next one, with the axial rotation of Earth, how this will be vary? Consider there is a mass m here at a latitude 5. Then, at this point, the acceleration to gravity is given by g phi is equal to g minus r omega square to cos square phi. So, there will be a decrease in acceleration to gravity because of axial rotation of Earth. Now, at the poles, if we go, what happens here? The phi will become 90 degree. Phi is 90 degree, means this cos square phi will become 0. G phi will be G. So, at the pole, there is no effect of rotation on this G. At the equator, what happens here? This will become cos phi will become 0. So, cos square phi will become 1. G phi will be G minus R omega square. So, the effect of this rotation will be on G will be maximum at the equator. So, next one is gravitational field. So, what is gravitational field? Gravitational field is a force, gravitational force per unit mass, F by M. Now, so if you know it is Gmm by R square, then the field equation is given by Gm by R square. For example, there is a mass, M is there, at a point P, because of this mass, how much gravitational field is there? What is the equation? It is Gm by R square. Next one, the field due to uniform solid sphere. This is solid sphere is there of radius R. Now, consider there is a point R here, inside the sphere. At this point r, what is the gravitational field? It is gm by r cube, where this r will be the radius of the sphere, and into r you get. Now outside the sphere, let's say here one point is there, point p and distance r, then outside the sphere it is given by gm by r square. At the surface if the point is there, the gravitational field will be gm by r square. Now, if you draw on a graph of the gravitational field versus distance from the center of the solid sphere, you will get the graph like this. From the center, at the center, you will get 0. Again, it will increase linearly up to the surface. Then, after the surface, outside the sphere, it will decrease exponentially. Now, consider consider it is a solid sphere. Or consider hollow sphere. Consider hollow sphere, you get like this. Inside it will be 0 again, which is a hollow. Then outside, after the surface, the electric gravitational field decreases as E is equal to gm by r square, which is a hollow sphere. Now, how you get the graph? You get the graph like this. Up to r radius, it will be 0. After that, it will decrease. So, like this, you will get graph for a of a field for a hollow sphere. This is for a solid sphere. So next one is gravitational potential. So what is gravitational potential? You have to take one unit mass, means 1 kg mass from infinity to that point against the gravitational field. Then how much work is done for unit mass, that is called gravitational potential. Now you have one equation. Consider there is a mass is mz at a point P, let's find the gravitational potential because of this mass. And the equation is given by minus gm by r, where r is the distance from the mass and this point. Now consider there is a uniform solid sphere instead of radius r. What will be the gravitational potential inside the sphere? Now consider there is a point you consider here inside and distance r from the center, and the gravitational potential is given by P is equal to minus gm by r cube into 1.5 r square minus 0.5 r square. Now outside the sphere, so outside the sphere it will be V is equal to minus gm by r. Now if you draw a graph, so you will get like this, r versus potential. Potential will get negative. So this will be the potential at the center. Center how much will get? Center this r will be 0. This r will be 0 means this is 0. 1.5 r square. 1 r will cancel. How much will get? Is minus gm by r will get. Into 1.5 you will get. Next one. So spherical shell. So for a hollow sphere. So what will be the gravitational potential because of this one? Now inside you will get here V is equal to minus gm by r over you get at any point. Consider we get r inside it will be minus gm by r, where r is the radius only. So entire is inside this V will be same. Now at the surface also you get the same minus gm by r. So what is the potential at the surface? Inside the potential will be 0. You have the reason for this one. Because inside this one field, gravitational field is 0. So what is the surface? How much work is done for surface? A, extra work is not needed to move a mass inside here. So the potential inside and surface will be same. Outside, it is minus gm by r, small letter r, where r is the distance from the center to that point. So next one is gravitational potential energy. So you have studied the gravitational potential V is equal to it is W by M. So work done. You can say it is as energy also. So energy what will get it is V into M. So here for example, the gravitational potential here, potential energy because of two masses M1 and M2. So what is this one? For example, is because of M1, the distance r, there will be a potential in there V. If you multiply M2, you will get the gravitational potential energy. So that is equal to minus G M1 M2 by R. Minus G M1 by R will be V. V multiplied by M2 will get the gravitational potential energy. Now, on the surface of Earth, this gravitational potential energy, how much you get? Is minus gm by r, it is V on the surface, into mass. So, it is minus gm m by r it is. So, next one is escape velocity from any planet. So, what is escape velocity? That particle you have to escape from the gravitational field. So on the surface there will be energy will be there, gravitational energy will be this much. Now for that particle you have to give some kinetic energy and you have to make total energy as 0. So minus gm m by r will be the potential energy plus kinetic energy, adding total energy will be become 0. So from this equation, escape velocity will get equation as root of 2gm by r, or also you can write as 2g root of 2gr. Now if you know the value, radius and g values, you put the value from the earth surface, you will get 11.2 km per second. You will get this much of value. Now, next one, motion of a satellite. Because Earth or any planet, satellite is revolving around the planet in distance r from the center. Then, if it is revolving or rotation, there will be some centripetal force is given by mv square by r. So, here the centripetal force is provided by the gravitational force that is equal to gmm by r square. So, the velocity, orbital velocity of that satellite of having mass m. So what you get is gm by r, root of gm by r you get. So next one is time period of the satellite. What is time period? So time taken by the satellite to complete full one cycle. So that is equal to total distance by orbital velocity you can write. So total distance will be 2 pi r. So it will be 2 pi r into orbital velocity, you know the equation, the root of gm by r you get. Now from this equation I can write 2 pi root of this r will go up, it will become root of r cube divided by gm. So here I can write t is directly proportional to root of r cube I can write, or I can write t square is directly proportional to r to the power 3 I can write. Next one, energy of a satellite. So potential energy you can write, it is minus gmm by r, directly you can write potential into mass of satellite. So kinetic energy will be half mv square, v is the velocity, orbital velocity of the satellite. You know the equation, it is gm by r, root of gm by r. So how much you get for kinetic energy? Half gmm by r will get. So total energy will be potential energy plus kinetic energy. If you add these two, you will get minus half gm by r will get. You can see here, total energy and potential energy. So potential energy, if you do half, you will get total energy. And here kinetic energy and total energy is same, only negative sign is there in total energy, magnitude will be same here, kinetic energy and total energy. So next one is Kepler's laws. So three laws are there. So first one is, what is that? All the planets revolve around the sun in a elliptical orbit, it will revolve. Next one, area velocity of a satellite is a constant. That means what? For example, here one, here sun is there, here one planet is there, it is revolving here. So consider here it is very near to sun compared to this portion here. Now here, if it is revolved like this, here what is the velocity will be here? More here. It will move fast. So here it will be slow, such that area covered by here at a given time t and this area at a given time t, it will be same. Area covered by a given time will be same. So dA by dt will be same, that is equal to L by 2m you will get. Next one, third Kepler's law is, it is time period. You got the equation here. T square is derivative to r cube. That is the third Kepler's law. Time period of a planet, square of that is direct proportional to cube of the distance from the that sun to that planet. Thank you.